white next shot. Now, in this position here, I'm going to play a thin cannon with the red ball, pushing the red ball along towards the pocket, clipping the white ball on the side here, on the right-hand side, and knocking it probably just out of the box. Next shot, I will pot that red ball and try to get on the natural angle there. Then the next shot I'll be playing in off the red here, and because the white ball is long, just outside the box, I'll be knocking the red ball off the side cushion. I'll explain that in a moment. First of all, though, I'll play this shot, and I'll bring my white ball back so that I can get that pot on every time. Now, I'll just pot this red ball and get on that natural angle. Now, as you can see now, I'm right on that natural angle. So a losing hazard player would like to go in off that ball and drive it up to the centre pocket so they could go in off. Now, I'm a top of the table player, so I want to bring that white ball back into play, and I'm going to just knock the red ball off the side cushion after going in off it and play a drop cannon to bring this white ball back and double the red off that side cushion over this pocket. As you can see, my last shot, it brought that red ball out a little bit far. I would have likened it to have been about down there for this drop cannon, but wherever they go, you've still got to play your shot. Now, so this drop cannon, from where it is, I'm going to play it fairly thick, about three-quarter ball into the red, to drive the red ball onto the cushion and back over towards that pocket, and taking the pace off my ball so that when it strikes the white ball, it shouldn't shift it too far. By playing that drop cannon onto that left-hand side of the white, it drove it into the box, and the red ball came off this cushion right over the pocket where it is, in perfect position. But because it is straight on, what I intend doing now is potting the red ball and sticking on it so as I'll be on that natural angle. Instead of trying to pot it and come over here for position, I'll stop on the angle, go in off the red ball in this pocket next shot, knock it over the centre pocket, pot it and come back, and I've scored 9 in the process. Now you can see where the balls are finished up after playing this drop cannon. I played off the red on the right-hand side of the red, fairly thick, to drive the red onto the cushion, across over that pocket, and then knocked the white ball, which was here, into the box, and now this is the position we're faced with. What I'm going to do now is try to hit my ball, or strike my ball, at 6 o'clock, and stick right on that spot where the red is, pocket the red, go in off the red next shot, knock it over the middle pocket, pot it and come back. If I can stop right on that natural angle, it's going to make this very easy, and I'll score 9 in the process, and I should come back down here somewhere for top of the table. That's one shot. Now, I'm a little bit off the angle, so I'm going to play this with a little bit of running side. I haven't got the red quite high enough, so I'll have to play a drop cannon again now. Now, I played that shot just right, but a little bit too hard, otherwise the white ball would have finished around here. So now I'm going to pot the red ball and go on the other side there so that I can get a cannon and bring that white ball back into play. Now, as you can see, the position there, Now, all that has been caused by that bad end off I played and didn't get the red quite high enough to pot it in the middle pocket. So I had to play a drop cannon. I played a little bit too thin on the red, not thick enough. If I'd have played the red a little bit fuller, I would have taken the pace off my cue ball so that when it contacted the white, it didn't shift it as far as it has. But now that it's here, I still want to get it back into that box, and it's a little bit of a narrow cannon, so I'm going to use right-hand side, striking my ball here at 3 o'clock, but taking the white ball off the cushion back into the box. Now, as you can see, I played it again a little bit too hard, and I'm very close to the spot. So what I'm going to do now is pop that red ball there and come back here a little bit so that I can get a cannon off the red ball. I just got the cannon there, just tipped it, and missed the pot. So now I'm going to cut the red ball in, and I've still got good position. Now this time I'm going to play the cannon off the white first. Now I'm putting very close to the spot, but I'll pot the red, and now I can pot the red, make two pots. A lot of top of the table, you can play two pots to every cannon, which I'm going to do now. Place the red ball back on the spot again, and you can see the perfect position that I've got. Now, that little segment that I've just played, I got out of position a few times. Things didn't work out quite the way I wanted them, but you don't despair, you just keep playing on. You can't always get absolutely perfect position. But I would show you now, with the ball's in this position, and you've got the white ball there, it's slightly that side of the center. So you do a lot of potting of the red. Red counts three. You can get two pots to every cannon. In this case, I will strike my ball down the bottom and draw it back a few inches, pot the red and get the cannon next shot. Perfect position. Now a little cannon next shot. Without shifting the white very far. Now there's quite a lot of potting in billiards, and particularly at top of the table. You just keep brushing that white. In this case, I pop the red again, get another three. Then just dribble the red through and just touch the white again. Another cannon with left-hand side now. I strike my ball here at 10 o'clock, follow through, and bring it off the cushion. Now apply a little cannon here, dribble it towards the spot. You still haven't shifted the white very far. Now I'll apply a cannon and strike my ball here about 10 o'clock. Follow through, bring it back off the cushion for a position for your cannon there. Another cannon, and just dribble the red towards the spot. Now this time, I can either stop on that and play the angle shot again, up to the centre, pop the red and come back, or come off for here. Now, I think it's best to play this shot and stay right on the angle. In off, you strike that ball at 6 o'clock, firmly, bang, and you'll stop your ball dead, and it's in perfect position. Put the red on the spot. Now I'll play the in off and drive the red over the centre pocket. always place your, in this particular position, place your ball so that your ball will finish about halfway from the centre to the cushion. And play it down the table, strike the cushion, and come back again. It's far better for it to come back too far this way and to finish up down here in an awkward position where you haven't got an angle shot. You've got to pot that red and go up too far. It's far better to come back like that, because now I can get a cannon off the cushion with a little bit of right-hand side, striking my ball here at 3 o'clock, dribbling the red towards the cushion and come like that. Because I know next shot now I can pot the red, go over here, play a cannon back off the white, bring it back into the box in a position like that. I'm just going to show you this once again, that if you're wanting to play a floating white and you want to keep the white ball back somewhere close to the spot, in a position like this, you just play that red about a quarter ball, just dribble it towards the pocket, and with enough strength, play off the cushion here with right hand side on your own ball, striking your ball at 3 o'clock, and it comes off the cushion. Now, depending on how much side you put on that ball, it depends on where you're going to strike that white. If you put not very much side, you'll strike the white here and push it over there. If you want to bring it back close behind the spot, you put more side on, so you strike it back there and brings it back towards the spot. Now, we just play it like this. The thing is that what you mustn't do, or try not to do, is knock that ball out of the box. It's quite all right where it is, because the red is in perfect position, because I played it thin, dribbled towards that spot, towards the pocket, I mean. Now I'm going to put that red and go around here where I've made the cross back here, and then I can play it back into the box again. Now from this position where I've just finished, I'm going to, if I want to bring that white back closer to the spot behind it, I play a little thin on the white to drive it to the cushion and bring it back here, and then the red ball must go towards the pocket. Now I've played it an extremely bad shot here, so what I'll have to do is try to get that white ball off that. Now what I'm going to do, I could pot that red and go in off the white, but I want to get the top of the table back again. So I'm going to pot that red and put a lot of side on my ball so that I'll be in a position when the red comes up on this spot. Now it comes back up onto this spot because it won't spot there. So I'll put it back on the spot, and now I can play this cannon and knock it off the spot. Play it thick onto the red and knock it off the spot, and there I've got top of the table again. Now what I've done here, I showed you what I would do because the white is just off the spot there and I want to play top of the table all the time. I played that red through there and finished up over here. Then I played a cannon off the red because the red must always go back onto the pyramid spot when the red spot is occupied. So the red goes there, I played the cannon and knocked the white off the spot, the red over that pocket and carried on with the break. Now there's an alternative here. I put the ball back where they were. I could pot that red softly and just come out practically where the red ball is, because the white ball is not quite on the spot. But the next shot I would play in off the white here, drive it onto the cushion out here, where I can get in off from balk. The following shot, now I'd play in off that, the red ball would be here, play in off there, then I'd be back in hand with the white ball here, my opponent's white, red on the spot. I would play and off the red in this pocket to take it over that centre pocket. Because once I play, I'm back in hand there, I can play it off that white, drop it down into the box, pop the red if it's up high enough, but you don't have to worry too much about that in off with the red there, because if it doesn't go to the centre pocket, I drop that white ball down there and play a drop cannon to bring it back into play. So there's no problems, no worry, but that's an alternative that you can play. As I've explained to you in several of the sequences that we've been doing, trying to get what you call perfect position is not always easy. In fact, it's hard to say that you get perfect position for anywhere, but you try to get your opponent's white ball in that box for top of the table. And believe me, if you strive to do that all the time, you'll find that your billiards will improve, and particularly your average. I would say to all players, keep an average. When you're playing a game, mark up every shot on the scoreboard so that at the end of a given time, you've scored so many points in a given number of shots. This is the only way that you'll find that you are improving at billiards. You can keep improving for a lifetime, but you'll find at the end of 6 months that instead of averaging 12, we'll say, you're now averaging 15, which shows you that you're improving and gives you heart to play on. But what you do, there's always an alternative. If the position doesn't work out perfect for you, because who's perfect? There's no one perfect, not even Walter. But you strive for the alternative shot to get back to the top of the table. I use quite a lot of drop cannons. I always reckon that between the centre pocket here and the top pocket, anywhere in this zone, and you're in hand, there's a white a ball here, either the red or the white, in that area, it's out of play while you're in hand. So you always drop the other ball down from the centre when you get the opportunity to bring it back into play. By the same token, here's a position where I've got an easy in off the white in the centre pocket, but the red ball is out of play from hand unless you're an extremely good pot. So what I always do in this particular case, instead of playing that in off the white and dropping it down to the cushion and then playing a cannon off the red, which you can do, you've got to drag the ball, play it softly to get your position. Whereas by playing it from balk here, onto the white ball, then onto the red, striking the red ball on the left-hand side, and the white ball strikes the side cushion and across towards the D. And you can get top of the table in one shot. Now from this position here, when I'm in hand, the red ball is out of play there. Now, it's quite possible to come play from here in off the white, drop the white ball down just on the right hand of the spot, and then play a soft cannon down off the red ball onto the white, leaving the red ball over the pocket. But I feel that this is a better shot, playing from hand here and playing a drop cannon full onto the white, about three-quarter ball, and getting onto the left-hand side of the red, playing it towards the pocket. The red should come, the white should come down towards the spot there. There it is there, perfect. I need the long shot, but I can play a pot the red there, back, the white's near the spot, and I'm in business straight away, playing top of the table. Now we're playing this shot once again to give you an idea of exactly where I'm striking my cue ball here. I'm striking it right here about 10 o'clock and striking your opponent's white fairly thick, a little bit to the right, about three-quarter ball. so that the white ball will contact the cushion there, across into the box around the spot, and cannon onto the left-hand side of the red, leaving it in a position over that pocket. We're playing this shot once again to let you see exactly where I'm striking the ball and the result. Now what's happened there, I've got on the wrong side of the red, and I can be in play by just playing a little thin cannon, and I've still got top of the table. Now you saw me play that drop cannon, and I got on the wrong side of the red, but by playing a thin cannon through, it still turned out all right. Now from here, I can bring that white ball out a bit and knock the red over there, because now I've got the white ball out, it gives you a bigger margin. Now I can play a little thin pot there. The red on the spot. I stun pot that and go over there. Cannon back off the cushion, and that gives us position again. Now, striking my ball down a little bit to stun it over there into position. The red ball back onto the spot. And now I come off the top cushion, dribble the red towards the spot. And never be frightened of knocking them up a little bit. Now all I've got to do is pop that red ball and go just there, simple shot, then another cannon off the white, and I've got them back in the box. And so it goes on. And this is top of the table. But never despair, there's always a shot on. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of the video. As you all know, there are thousands of shots in billiards, but you can't possibly play them all in one video. We've deliberately cut the video to a reasonable length because we didn't want to bore people with it, and all we wanted to do was to get that message through to try to help all the players, from the weaker players to the stronger players. I'm quite sure that you will all get some benefit from this video, but before going on further, I would like to thank a number of people associated with this video. First of all, the Henson boys, Arthur and Max Henson, who trade under the name of Armax Billiards. I've known these boys all my life. In fact, I knew their parents before they were married. So that'll give you some idea in the length of time I've known them. But they have done a wonderful job with billiards. They started off from furniture manufacturers, and since they've come into the billiard game, they've gradually improved until now their product is second to none. They're doing a wonderful job. I wish them well. I thank them very much for helping us with the video. I would like to thank, too, the cameraman, Neil Roper. Neil has done a tremendous job with one camera to get the various angles and shots that we've played. It admittedly has taken quite a long time. It's taken us several days. But Neil's done a tremendous job, and I thank him very much. I would like to thank Polly. Polly has helped us tremendously with this video. In fact, I don't know how we'd have done it without him. He's done a wonderful job. Thanks very much, Polly. There are two other people that I should have mentioned there that want to remain anonymous. I thank them very much for their support for making the video. I'd also like to thank my good wife, who has been putting up with us for several days here to make this video. I thank her most sincerely. At this stage, I would like to draw attention to this photo that is put here of Walter and I. Walter was my mentor, and what a wonderful player he's been. And this photo was Walter and I meeting back in 1936, when Walter reminded me this was the first world title that I'd won, reminded me that we were now both the world professional and the world's amateur champions, and we're both born in Kalgoorlie. That the odds against that would be thousands to one against. But in going back over the video a little bit, the sponsors and myself hope that everyone gets the benefit out of a video that we have been expecting. I have deliberately shown top of the table, played very openly, so that any players, no matter how poor they are at the start, have got something to strive for, instead of like the pros play that white ball very close to that red spot. It's not necessary, you can still make hundreds of breaks with playing the open top of the table, floating wide and postman's knock. So we hope that everyone gets some benefit from it and you've got something to practice for. And if I could make 1,000 breaks or made 3 playing this type of billiards, I'm quite sure that you can do the same. I wish you well. Happy billiards.